Hey everyone, my name's Hope Yoder and I love Tiffany's Jig. I'm going to open it up into any software program and yours may look differently, but what I want to do is just grab one of the watch bands. I'm going to delete everything else. Now, if you can't ungroup the watch band jig, then go ahead and try to break apart or release compound path, depending on what software program you're working on. The point is you want one full band for the two different sizes. And then I save those as a brand new name. And I always send that to my Glowforge with a design centered. So however your software lets you do it, by breaking apart, releasing compound path, or ungrouping, just save one of each of the bands. So now I can paste this in a new window and I save this under a brand new name like my template, and I make a copy and put it somewhere else so that I don't ruin it. Now what I'm going to do that for the other size band, and then you've got a template. Make sure you name it something brand new. Now here's my graphic. I am going to just take whatever graphic you want to center on the band, and I'm going to take care to move and center it. And this will just take a minute to show you how to do it. I zoom in. I use the nudge keys on the keyboards. Now I'm using Craft and Cut software program from R&K Distributing. Doesn't matter what program you use, just whatever you're comfortable with to get that centered. And I'm going to do the same thing on the other side of the band. Caution, make sure you don't get close to the edge where the metal attachments go. I like to leave about, I think about 17 millimeters from the straight edge, right where the band starts to curve down. Just make sure you don't have any text in that area, and you'll be fine. So I actually zoom in real big and I use my ruler to make sure it's centered. Once I have all of that done, I'm going to just group everything and I'm going to export it as an SVG. Now I use recycled cardboard, take off all the tape, send the file to the Glowforge. And what you're going to want to do is use cardboard to cut out the jig. And don't make sure you don't remove the cardboard, just cut it out, pop your watch bands in here, and secure them however you want. So what I did is I ignored everything except for the outline. And then I put my watch bands in, and now I am going to ignore the watch band, cut out, and engrave the other settings. I do this every single time, and it's always perfect. I put a little pin in here. Sometimes I'll put tape on the end of the band. I shorten here, you can see the one I'm wearing. It's always perfect. I like to engrave the name first as well, because there is a lot of wind inside of there and I want the name to be centered. When I'm all done, it looks like this. I take it out and I am going to wash it and follow Tiffany's directions to get a band that's perfect every time. So hope this helps you guys.